this is the calculator section of this this paper, SAT paper 5. Now let us start working on the problems over here. Now see, what about question number 1? Now this is the number of 3D movies released over, and this is the year. Now according to the line graph above, between which two consecutive years was there the greatest change in the number of 3D movies released? So when you are looking at the number of the greatest change, you are looking at the slope. So where is the slope greatest over here? So isn't the slope greatest? Intuitively, can we not see it is greatest over here between 2009 2010 or 2010 2011 over here? So the answer over here is nothing but, over here the answer is 2010 to 2011 over here. Over here it is very very clear that the steepness of the curve is between 2010 and 2011. In fact, you don't even have to compute it, you can see it from the steepness of the curve. So answer is D over here. Now some values of the linear function are given in the table below. Which of the following defines fx? So I can simply write y equal to ax plus b, and I can put the values of phi over here. Phi is equal to over here a plus b, and 13 is equal to 3a plus b. Now what is your 13 is equal to 3a plus b, and this is your 5 is equal to a plus b, is equal to a plus b. This is your, so we can find out a and b. This is your 8 is equal to 2a, so a is equal to 4. See, we are getting the slope as 4. So of course, out of all the options, C would meet the linear function, would meet the equation over here. So over here it is C. Now to make a bakery's signature chocolate muffin, a bakery needs, a baker needs 2.5 ounces of chocolate for each muffin. How many pounds of chocolate are needed to make octet signature chocolate muffins over here? So 48 signature muffins require 2.5 into 48 ounces. So over here 16 ounces is equal to 1 pound. So 1 ounce over here is nothing but 1 by 16, and this is your 48 signature is nothing but 1 by 16 into over here, not 48, so can we not write it as 2.5 into 48 ounces multiplied 1 by 16 into 2.5 into 48, so 16 into 3 is over here 48, so 2.5 into 3 will give us 7.5. So the answer is 3 over here. Now moving forward, what is the value of C plus D? It's nothing but 5 by 3. So you are just taking 3 below, so you are getting 5 by 3. Now what about 6th one? An online bookstore sells novels and magazines. Each novel sells for $4 and each magazine sells for $1. If CD purchased a total of 11 novels and magazines, they have a combined selling price of $20. How many novels did she purchase here? So let us say X is the number of novels and Y is the number of magazines. So 4X plus over here $1 for each magazine would give us over here 30, and X plus Y would give us the total number of magazines and novels purchased would be 11. So I'm multiplying the first equation by 4 over here. So this becomes 44x plus 4y. So this is your 44. I'm subtracting the 2. So this becomes 3y. 3y is nothing but over here 14. So 3y is nothing but 14. So y is equal to 14 by 3. Y is equal to 14 by 3. And we know x plus y is equal to 11. So x is equal to 11 minus 14 by 3. 14 by 3. So this will be 33 minus 14 by 3. So this is your 19 by 3. So this is your 19 by 3. Now let me again write in computation, the arithmetic is not coming out. So 4x plus 3, this is 20, I'm sorry, this will be 20 over here. So this would be over here 24, and y would be equal to 8. Therefore x would be equal to over here. See, this is a small error that has crept up in the computation. So 11 minus 8 would be 3. I'm rectifying the error. It's an arithmetic error. So arithmetic errors are easier to rectify than logical errors. So this is x is equal to 3. So the answer is 3 over here.